Hi, I'm Craig Williams, and today I'd like to talk to you about worms. In fact, I'm going to introduce you to a guy who's got worms, and I don't mean that kind of like, ooh, he's got worms, but he has got some of the most important worms in medical science. Today I want to talk to you about nematodes, or roundworms. Now, these are so incredibly abundant, you wouldn't believe. In a square meter, there could be almost 1 million of them. They occupy almost every habitat on the earth, every moist bit of soil, rotting vegetation, the water, and they cause some of the world's worst parasitic diseases. If you just think of hookworm, pinworm, in dogs, it's heartworm, in a lot of developing countries, it's filariasis. These worms, these nematodes, do it, yet I'll bet almost none of you have ever even seen one. But today, we are gonna see one. We're gonna go see the guy who's got worms. We're gonna go take a closer look at how they do their thing. Come with me. Dr. Nikki Thomas, who's one of the research fellows here at UniSA. Good morning, Nikki.
Hey, Greg.
Hey, okay. And PhD student, Chelsea Thorne.
Hello.
And Chelsea is a worm farmer. She's gonna tell us all about that. But first of all, where are the worms and can you tell me all about it?
Well, the worms are literally next door.
Right. Can we go take a look?
Sure.
All right, brilliant.
This is an incubator room.
Okay.
And we keep those worms at around 14 degrees Celsius. And this is the ideal temperature for them to grow, to multiply. And this way we can basically very cheap maintain a decent stock of the worms, which we can then use for our research.
Okay, so I was explaining to people before that, you know, there are you know, squillion different types of these worms out in nature, in the sea, in soil. What worms do you have?
So these worms are C. elegans, so these are nematodes, worms that live normally in soil. And they feed on all sort of debris in the soil. And what we do, we use them for our research investigating antibiotic resistance.
Before we have a close look at these guys, what do you actually use them for in your research?
Right, so these worms we use to, we infect the worms with bacteria.
Yep.
So we basically provide them with food that comprises of bacteria.
Yep.
So they ingest the bacteria, and the bacteria continue to grow in their intestine. So the bacteria grow and form a biofilm inside the worm intestine. And then what we then do, we give them we give the worms a treatment with antibiotics or whatever, more state-of-the-art formulations that we produce in our research, and then we investigate how well do the worms respond to the treatment. So what we see is basically a we can follow the survival of the worms following the infection.
Okay.
So if they are not being treated, they die fairly quickly within a couple of days, and if we treat them, we can see they get back to a kind of a healthy population. And we can also do all sort of fancy things like extracting the bacteria from inside the worms. We can investigate how many bacteria are still alive inside the worms. We can also take nice pictures of them. We can do that later.
Okay, sounds fantastic. Chelsea, thanks a lot for sharing your worms with us. I think I can say that. It's been fantastic to actually get a proper close-up look at them, and good luck with all your research.
Thanks.
Thank you.